votes in session. Now here come the judge. Here come the judge.
Here come the judge.
What are you looking at?
You too.
Okay.
like you've got your claws out and sharpened, evil stepmother.
All the better to make a point with, my dear. And, stepmother will do just fine for you.
Thank you.
All right! Introducing the Fairy Godmother!
Out of order.
at that last statement, and you may step down, my dear.
I'm good. I need a nap.
Right this way.
Dear, is Katy Perry a valid option?
No, I was thinking more right in front of you. Beautiful.
What about Pig Benny?
No!
Then you are the fairest of them all, my dear.
Yes. One day, I was happily
my Dutch door.
Your Honor,
up, that is... up. Snow White, this isn't a beauty contest. So it doesn't matter how ugly the Wicked Witch is, you're not to mention it.
Oh, if I had my spell book!
Well, you don't. It's safely locked away as evidence. Little Red continues.
So the ugly face of the defendant appeared at your Dutch door?
Your Honor, that is like the third...
The jury is admonished to forget the word in Dutch. It doesn't matter what kind of door it was.
What did the defendant do? She offered us an apple, which you took and ate. Well, I had one, but Esteban had one, it wasn't that big a deal.
Okay, then what happened?
Well, what happened, Esteban? We dropped dead.
Dropped dead?
Yeah. Was trying kind of awful, just a little bit.
Your witness?
Now, this way. Have you ever seen your stepmother talk to or meet my client?
No, but you know.
Just answer the questions, please.
I don't like you.
Okay. And why did my client offer you an apple?
Oh, she said it was to welcome us to the neighborhood.
Okay. So she didn't strike fear into your heart?
Not really.
Okay. You weren't terribly scared?
No, but...
Just answer the questions, please. So, then apparently you dropped dead.
That's what the paramedics said.
And you were buried?
Well, not really. You see, we were just so beautiful that the little men just couldn't stuff us underground. Thank goodness. They put us in a crystal box.
I see. Yeah. And then what happened?
A guy came along and gave Esteban a kiss. That's when he woke up, and then he kissed me, and I woke up too.
So you weren't really dead at all?
Not really.
So people who are dead don't just wake up, do they?
I guess not.
So my client really didn't do anything.
What was her apple?
Is this the apple?
Oh, no! No!
Your Honor, all happy and apples with life.
Your Honor, the forensics team found this line near Sundor's cottage and found no poison on it whatsoever.
But you can't be sure that that's the apple the witness ate.
But if it was, it wasn't poisoned. That's all, Miss White.
You may step down, my dear.
I don't like you.
Okay.
But Esteban, we must go now.
No one likes her anyway.
Next witness, little Red.
Hansel and Gretel to the stand.
Coming
right up.
How do you think we're doing?
They haven't proven a thing. What about these two coming up?
I told ya, I've never seen her before in my life.
Introducing Hansel and Gretel.
Big fancy schmancy dinner that night, and Mom went to the truffles.
we skipped into the woods.
Hang on, you were still skipping at that stage?
Yeah, we were happy, carefree, little kids. Got a problem with that?
It's a little lame.
I
have
a problem.
Keep going. We took along breadcrumbs and dropped them so we could find our way back.
Einstein here thought that one up.
Give me a break. I was only 7.
I told you we should have brought string, but no.
Alright, so your dropped breadcrumbs have ended up deep in the woods?
Yeah, and it started to get dark. We tried to find our way back, but we got lost.
And whose fault was that?
So, would you stop and ask for directions? No!
Alright, so you're lost. What did you two do?
She cried.
So did you!
Yeah, well, not as much as you.
I meant, how did you meet the defendant?
Oh, well, that was easy. After walking a bit, we came upon this cottage made out of gingerbread, and it was covered with frosting and candy.
My decorator worked for the food channel.
Evil stepmother, any more output like that, and your client will be cited for contempt.
We understand, Your Honor.
Did you knock on the door?
With all that candy and frosting? No, we just started to eat.
Mom had only packed us a little lunch, so we were hungry.
That's understandable. Did you eat much?
Not that you could notice.
He pulled off an entire quarter and a good chunk of the room.
Out us.
She locked the door and threw me in a cage.
What'd she do to you, Gretel?
She thought I was the mayor and maid or something. I had to do the cooking, cleaning, polishing, you name it. I was her slave while she fattened up butterball here.
It wasn't my fault. Everything she fed me was made out of butter, cream, and sugar.
Why did she do that?
She was going to cook Hansel and eat him.
Gretel found an internet recipe for oven-roasted child.
Then one day, she told me to fire up the oven. And we're not talking a toaster oven either. The big one.
And then she pulled me out of the cage. I was so full of sugar goo, I didn't know what was happening. And then she plopped me in a pan and brushed me with more butter.
Then she told me to see if the oven was hot enough.
And did you?
Well, I didn't really know how to do that. So I asked her to show me. She laughed this big sigh and rolled her eyes and said something about dumb kids. Then she opened the oven door and stuck her head inside.
This is all you do,
dearie, she said.
That's what I told Gretel. Shove her in.
You did not. I thought of it all myself.
It doesn't matter. You shoved her in
and slammed the door shut.
And then we ran out of there as fast as we could.
Which wasn't very fast because they had to roll butterball.
It wasn't my fault.
You eventually made it home?
Yeah, and when we got home, Mom called the cops. But when the cops went out into the woods, they couldn't find her. The whole house had been eaten by squirrels and birds.
Only a few crumbs were left.
And how did that experience affect you two?
I've been in therapy for 10 years.
My doctor said I was cured 2 years ago, so then.
You were witnesses? Okay, Hansel and Gretel. My client took you in and gave you a home when you were homeless. Is that correct?
Well, not exactly.
She gave you shelter and food.
Yes, but...
So yes, and in the day in question, she asked you to heat up the oven. Is that correct, Gretel?
Yeah, so?
But she never told you what she intended to bake in the oven.
No, but it was pretty obvious. No.
Okay, so, after she told you, and then she put you in a pan and, well, Hansel in a pan and buttermilk.
Yeah,
correct?
And if she wasn't gonna bake me, why else would she do that?
Well, you had complained about something the night before, hadn't you?
What are you talking about?
You were bitten by little no-see-ums?
Yeah, so?
Well, one of the ways to stop those bugs from biting, and I quote, from a book by I Am Itchy, a notable dermatologist, a light coating of butter will prevent most bites.
What? She was going to bake him
Wicked Witch find you, or did you find her?
What kind of question is that?
Just answer it.
You're making it look like it was all our fault.
I'll take that as we found her.
Are you just gonna let her do that?
That's her job.
And I think pretty well.
Come on, Gretel, let's go find some cool kids to hang out with.
Yeah, this place is for stuffy old fogey.
What's he?
Stuffy!
Stuffy old fogey my bottom.
Yes, Daddy.
Can I go get my chair?
Help yourself. And the state may call its next witness.
The state calls Rapunzel.
Go get Rapunzel, Benny. Benny, wake up. Wake up.
What did you learn for?
She told me to.
She's not a coward.
No,
she did. Benny, it is time for Rapunzel. Go get Rapunzel.
Well, yeah.
What?
watch is missing.
Okay, well, so do I. You could have gotten it anywhere, sister.
Oh, well, I never.
This witness is excused.
Okay, well, it's been real. It's been fun, but it hasn't been real.
Jury members, I am very sorry for that absolutely horrible singing. So I have one special prize for one lucky jury member. Who wants it? Let's see the heads. Have you any other witnesses, little Red?
One more, Your Honor. St. Paul's Prince Charming.
Prince Charming? He's here?
Life.
Really?
Your wish is not a matter, lady.
know, Snow White?
Delightful girl, absolutely delightful.
How did you meet her?
Well, one morning I was traveling from Redfield as I heard the damsel crying a crystal coffin off in a neighboring kingdom. I rode over, and there she was with seven little men crowded around her crying. I was so taken by her beauty as well, I had to give her a nice, great big kiss, too.
And she woke up?
I can't explain it.
You became acquainted?
We dated for 3-4 months.
And during that time, did Snow White tell you what happened to her?
Something about a wicked witch or stepmother wanted to get rid of her. Also, can you hear me that?
Yeah. She mentioned a wicked witch, right?
Emphatically.
Did you ever come into contact with this wicked witch?
Well, one morning I rode by to see Snow White. By this time I helped Snow get rid of all her problems, shall we say, and Snowy was restored to power. Anyway, there she was, in her garden, on her throne, ordering servants about, and this old hag came hobbling up to her with a basket of apples and said,
"Have an apple, dearie."
Snowy screamed and ran into the old thing.
Is the old hag the defendant?
This lovely lady? I hardly think so.
If I wasn't so great, I'd blush.
All right, we'll give it one more try this time.
Anything for you, little red.
Ever hear of Rapunzel?
Rapunzel? Rapunzel. Let down your... Jeez, now what was it again?
Hair!
Let down your hair.
See, what? I told you you were stupid.
I just said that. As a thank you for giving me the image.
Did the defendant lock Rapunzel up in a tower?
Miss lovely lady, I hardly think so. But Ruby did mention something about an old crone seeing her way when she was just a girl and locking her up in that tower. The place didn't even have a window. I had a door, sorry, door. I had to climb up the poor girl's hair just to get in the window.
And how did you get down from the tower?
I had this incredible surcane. Well, with my dagger, we shredded into strips and tied the strips together and held down the side of the tower. Piece of cake for a hunk like mom.
And what about the old crone?
We never saw her again.
Is she in this courtroom?
Look, everybody in here is just so nice to have done something like stick poor Rapunzel up in that tower.
I give up, your witness.
Thank you. So, Prince Charming, you have met 3 of the most beautiful girls in Lost Planet.
4.
No? Oh?
Don't forget yourself.
somebody open a window!
I don't know what our witness is buttering up the defense attorney.
What do you have against butter?
It's just part of my charm, little Ren.
Objection overruled.
Okay. So you dated all 3 of the girls mentioned earlier?
I did.
But you never said I do.
I didn't.
Plus the experiences you had have caused you no physical or psychological injuries?
No way! I am pale and hearty.
Did my clients attempt to ever thwart your attempt at rescuing the princesses?
That's where you go to Dawson Clear? No way! I mean, I ran into a fire-breathing dragon trying to save Sleeping Beauty. And of the old crow, just with a pretty mean walking stick, just before I found Snow White. And this meanest buzzard kept pecking at me, climbing up the tower to Rapunzel.
Couldn't have been
your clients.
I object, Your Honor. The witness is drawing a conclusion.
You're always complaining. He's just answering the question.
With a conclusion, not a fact.
Oh, dear, little Red does have a point.
Then here's a fact. That sweet little lady sitting there never bothered me one bit.
Objection overruled.
Cinderella, what are you doing here? I had to testify first, honey bun.
About what? Cinderella, we are in the middle of the trial of the Wicked Witch.
Oh, so they finally got you, stepmom.
Cinderella, you are out of order.
Well, let me tell you this, jury. She's guilty. She treated me like dirt till I met her ring up the club the other night.
I did.
The club she tried to keep me from going.
Cinderella, I'm going to have to ask you to leave at once.
Seriously, hon, I'll be done in a minute.
Come on, everyone! Catch me! Catch
right. We are the characters of Once Upon a Time. Disposition of this matter.
A diamond pain!
Oh, Weezer, pain, all right.
Watch it, Porky! You'll be visiting Douglas tonight.
Now there'll be none of that. Return to your seats.
Right here with you, witch. And this time, you're not getting wet.
Oh, no. Oh, no, witch, because I have something very special in mind for you. Bats and bells, farmers in the dells, glue the wicked there she'll stay throughout the day till the trial is complete.
I object! Those are not allowed to cast spells during trial.
Overruled.
Hey, I can't get up!
Told you so.
Now,
your honor!
I said overruled, you stepmother. Now get on with your defense, if you have one.
Upon a time in the kitchen.
Can you please be a bit more precise?
Now
I've got a matchmaking gig tonight. I just hope it doesn't involve more of the Wicked Witch's handiwork. Call your next witness, evil stepmother.
Okay? The defense calls Rumpelstiltskin.
Me to go get him.
Oh, poor little Benny. I wouldn't want to interrupt your beauty sleep.
Hey!
Hi.
You already finished it?
Sorry, I never noticed.
Little Red, you're a prosecutor. Arrest my sister.
Benny, it was clearly a
just call me? You called me by my other name, didn't you?
She did.
How dare you? You promised you'd never say my other name. You promised! You're so wicked and mean! Me! You're no better than that darn milkmaid! None of you are! I'm going to spit as you out of this mirror! I'll hit you all!
She ran it.
She ran it?
Yep.
kind of felt like an enchanted forest.
But it was the Emerald City, controlled by the Wizard of Oz.
No, it was a different Emerald City.
What other Emerald City is there?
The one where it rains a lot.
Izzy, Debbie, you're lying, aren't you?
Us? A lie?
You sure got a lot of opinions of us.
Help me out then and tell the truth
for a change.
Ooh, for a change.
How much we talking? All right, the biggest richest charm school was in the Emerald City. How many students were there?
Maybe 10, 15?
100. 1,500?
If you count the next student.
And all of these people came to learn how to cast charms themselves?
Yeah. They taught us from a book.
I think it's that one.
This one, maybe, over here?
Yeah.
Maybe.
The Giants of the Spells?
Ooh.
That one?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I took the liberty of copying down a few potions and spells, some basic ones, and I have a few questions. Can you tell me what ingredient needed for love potion number 8?
I knew.
Sorry, that's love potion number 10.
Juron, these witnesses are not here for a test.
I'm going to overrule that objection. We'll see how good teacher the Wicked Witch was.
Izzy, what are the words that will change a frog into a mosquito? Hippity, bippity, ribbity, buzz, bashito, comito. Zippity buzz?
Ooh, wrong. It's Bazicho Comito. Not Bashito. Bashito.
Oh, rabbit.
Your Honor, she's splitting hairs.
Okay.
I am impressed, little red, that Izzy knows any spell regarding a frog.
Oh, great. I'm not stupid, you know.
That topic is up for debate.
Desi, at what time of day do you say the words that will build
I gave up popping and popping. Until your house is low now, I've moved on.
To where?
I got tired of wondering where my next meal was going to come from.
You mean Grandma's safe in the forest?
Absolutely, and so are her investments.
What are you talking about?
I'm on Wall Street now. Maybe me and Benjamin have been hanging out quite a bit.
Let me open by asking you how old you were when the incident at the gingerbread cottage took
There's no telling what she'll do if she gets a hold of this.
But little Red, think of the characters once upon a time and really might need 911.
Really? And poor Jack's back looked awful this morning. Like he was just about ready to fall over.
And poor Jack Horner's got that bum thumb.
Don't forget about little Bold Pete. She's lost all her sheep and he's not finding them.
Her sheep, Red.
Is this all right?
Just for one spell.
All right then, just for that one spell.
Yeah!
Gretel, what is the main cause of your pent-up anger?
Oh, I'm sorry. The main cause of my pent-up anger is having to roll Butterball all the time!
Okay.
Separate them. Thank you.
Sleeping Beauty, how has your sleeping disorder affected you?
It hasn't affected me that much.
That's a lie.
They take you to sleep pays, and I mean, they're not lying.
Thank you. Just touching the little glasses. Beautiful lady right here.
Has your stepmother influenced you and your sister's testimony by bribing me with the privilege of driving a car?
Well,
No. I see. Well, hands. Let's go to this side of the room. Right in my face. Oh, yeah. Anyone? No one? No one? No one?
Oh, there's
3rd, the week before Ashley graduates. Oh my God, it's right around the corner. Thank you guys so much. Awesome job. Thank you all for watching.